I'm Glenn Morris from the Smart Energy Lab, and I'm here at All Energy today with Bob from Solinteg.
Yes.
Now, Bob, Solinteg, I've just learned about Solinteg since we met on LinkedIn.
Yeah.
But you're a new brand to Australian market.
Yeah, it's
a new brand. But not in China.
So, not in China.
So tell me some facts about Solinteg.
Yeah, Solinteg is new here in Australia, but we have been working in European market for some time, and we got good delivery there in Europe, and also we also fulfilled some projects working with the national grid back in China.
Right.
So we also had, we are also developing our distribution network in China, in European, and we are here now.
Right. Yeah. Wow. So China Light and Power, the biggest grid operator in the world.
That's true, that's true. That's true.
Yeah. I remember meeting some people from China Light and Power, and I said, oh, well, you must have like 1 billion customers. And they say 1.3.
Yeah. Like
Brazil as well.
Yeah, that's true.
Huge, huge.
That's true. So they have a very strict requirement for the component, for,
yes,
for the products for their project.
Yes.
And after testing our product first, and after we work with our local partner, to try to beat the requirement, meet the requirement, they finally chose us in their hybrid pilot project. And hopefully in future, we will have more delivery in their projects in China.
That's great.
Yes.
Now you mentioned the word hybrid.
Yes.
Both of the inverters we're going to look at today are,
yes,
hybrid inverters. So,
yeah,
so
hybrid.
Battery, solar, and grid.
That's true.
Yeah,
right. That's true, yeah.
So Bob, yeah. This is the residential hybrid inverter?
Yeah, this is a 3 to 8 kilowatt single phase hybrid inverter. It's very suitable for conventional residential application. Yes.
Right.
Yes.
So it's got all the features people love. It's got dual MPPT.
Yeah, dual MPPT. Yeah, that's true.
So it's got battery port.
Battery port.
And can you take full power on the battery port?
Yeah, yeah. That's also a big feature of our hybrid inverter. We can take four powers.
I think it was 30 amps.
Or? Yes, 30 amps.
Wow.
So this one, 30 amps, it's compatible with almost all the solar panels we use in Australia for rooftop applications.
Yes.
All the solar panels we use nowadays.
Oh yes, for the DC input current.
For the DC.
Very high.
That's true, that's true.
Yeah.
And this one, yeah, that's this 30 watt, it's works very well with the most popular batteries in the market. So no worry about the compatibility with the solar panels, with the batteries, no worry about that.
Now, most batteries have a communication with,
yes,
the inverter. Is this what we've got here?
Yeah, that's true.
So
the communication port is here. Yeah.
So this is battery communication, but also smart meter?
Yes,
all right.
That's true.
And these are the grid and backup port.
Yes, yes.
Now you said this is 5 to 8 kilowatt models?
Yeah, three to eight.
Oh, 3 to 8.
Yes.
Okay. And in the 8 kilowatt, for instance, can you get full power in backup?
Yeah, that's for sure.
8 kilowatts?
8 kilowatts.
Well, that's what we need.
Yes.
Because homes don't use 2.5 kilowatts.
Yes,
we need high power backup. Very,
yeah,
very
that's
good.
True. And if the grid is not, it can work independently as fixing the off-grid application.
Yes.
Yes.
So it can run with solar and battery and still supply your backup circuit.
Yes.
So
yes,
no worries about the blackout.
Yes, no worry about that.
Oh, that's
no headaches about that.
Yeah. Yeah. And I really like the display, which,
yes,
we can see on the wall there.
Yes.
It's very simple to know if it's working.
Yeah, that's true. That's,
yep,
true. There's some, we call this one breathing light. So it's actually breathing.
Oh, it Oh, yeah, it goes bright and dark.
Not just the change of the colors, but also
the brightness.
The brightness.
So it's heartbeat. You know that the heart of your machine is alive.
That's true.
That's really good.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's more friendly to the end users. Yeah.
Well, let's look at the big unit you've got here.
Yeah, yeah.
This is a big inverter.
Yeah, this is the big boy.
Yeah, yeah. How much power do we get here?
This one goes up to 50 kilowatts for one unit.
50 kilowatts?
50 kilowatts.
And it's hybrid?
Hybrid, that's true.
That's a pretty awesome hybrid inverter. So 50 kilowatts of AC output power?
Yes.
But from the battery?
Yes.
How much power?
This one also goes to full power.
Full power?
Yeah, for the batteries.
Right, so in off-grid mode, when the grid has failed, you still have 50 kilowatts of AC power.
That's true.
Now, in terms of DC inputs, you've got a lot of DC inputs along here.
Yeah, yeah, that's true. We have got 4 MPPT, and for each MPPT, we have got 2 PV strands.
Yes.
Yes, so we've got like 8 strands for that PV connection.
Wow, there's plenty of choices there. So you can get about, 75 kilowatts of PV on this?
Depending on the location you install this equipment, but 75 kilowatts should be fine.
Right.
Yes, and we can see this one is a horizontal design.
Yes.
So even if we have like 8 different string connection, so it's very easy for you because you have enough space back there.
Yes.
For you to connect and also disconnect, which is very important in, you know, some maintenance work. People disconnect them, it's more complicated.
I like what you're saying, because as an installer, disconnecting these can be a real challenge because they're too close together.
Yeah,
so there's plenty of space.
That's true.
Now, in the Australian market, 100 kilowatt AC power is a very popular target.
Yeah.
So this is 50. Can you do 2 of them?
Yeah, we can do actually 10 of them.
10 of them?
Yeah, to make it like 500 kilowatts.
Whoa.
So the PV input will be like 750 to like 800.
Yes.
So 800. So this one covers very big part of the commercial and small industry applications.
So 800 kilowatts of PV.
Yeah.
500 kilowatts of AC power.
Yeah, that's true.
Out of 10 of these.
Yes.
And they work as one.
Yeah, yeah, that's true. And it's like a master and a slave working mode. And we call this one distributed energy. So this one connects with batteries and all the 10 different inverter connecting with different racks of batteries. So even if one of them is not working properly, doesn't affect the whole system. This is very friendly.
So are you saying over the 10 inverters share one rack of battery?
No, 10 racks. 10 racks.
Right.
10 racks.
So it gives you a lot of redundancy.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. Wow. And you've got the usual communication port, I noticed.
Yeah, that's true.
And you've got 2 DC isolators. That's interesting.
Yeah, for one DC isolator, I'm managing 2 different MPPTs.
Yes.
So separating.
Right. So pairs of MPPTs per DC isolator.
That's true. That's
and you've got the wonderful a heartbeat display.
Yeah, heartbeat. Yeah,
heartbeat.
And a different colors, different heartbeats.
Yeah. And it even has an OLED display, I believe.
That's true. This is the logo of our company and also the button.
Ah.
So when we press the button, so we see the different information.
I see the logo.
That's true.
Yes,
that's the Mobius strip.
The Mobius strip. I know it.
Yeah.
2 dimensions.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. Means endless.
Yeah.
So it means also the power we get from the sun is also endless. So we try to deliver all the as much energy from the sun to the households, to our customers.
That's
the meaning of that strip.
So people watching this video in Australia, they'll be saying, where can we get these from? Will they be available in Australia soon?
Yeah, very soon. So we are working on the CC listing at the moment.
Yes.
We hope to get them down by the end of December.
Yes.
So most probably from 2023, we'll have these machines available in Australia.
Right.
Yes.
Right. You've got the C&I market covered for hybrid. So there's not a lot of choice when it comes to hybrid high-powered inverters.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
That's true. Especially these days. From global level, global market, we see a lot of EV running.
Yes.
For example, for some shopping centers, like 200 to 300 kilowatt applications, this one might be a very good choice to them.
Yes.
Yes. So when they, for example, if the shopping center upgrade the network, distribution network, it's cost a lot of time and a lot of money.
Yes.
But this one helps them to solve the problem.
So this buffers that demand. So they might have an 800 amp supply, which is not big enough for all the EVs, but this can add to that. Yeah,
that's true.
Yeah. It's been really good learning about Solinteg, and I look forward to opening one of these in a box.
Yes, let's do that. Yeah. Yes.
I'll link it up here in the video so you can see the unboxing. It'll be coming soon.
Yes.
Thanks very much, Bob.
Thank you very much for dropping by.
Ah, pleasure.
Yes.